Tony Bellew's illustrious career has come to an end. He lost in KO defeat to Alexander Usyk over the weekend in an 8-round fight. That was a truly, truly great fight. Tony Bellew was outboxing the boxer. He was doing well, making great movements, and he would turn away so that Alexander Usyk had have to reset his attack, which is a great tactic that he probably put together with Dave Caldwell. The way that Tony Bellew handled himself in there says a lot about the kind of fighter he is. In the end of the day, yes, he did lose, but he kind of showed me things that I didn't think he could do. I knew he was a great fighter, a great boxer, and was a great student of the game, and willing to learn and pick up new attributes. He was a fighter who always moved forward, and was going with the ages, going with the time, picking up new different skills, and finding ways to beat an opponent that was probably more technically gifted than him. That is what has got him so far in his career. But in this fight, he came short. But still, I think he's shown more of what he can do. He is a great fighter and a great boxer, and he's shown that in this fight. He fought well, he just got a little bit tired at the end, I think. And when he was stopped, it was that shot that sent him back to the ropes, and he kind of bounced back. You could see he was gone then, and all it took was two hard shots, and he was over. He was brave to try and get up, but the fight was already stopped by then. I like to say that it doesn't matter, but obviously it matters to Tony Bellew. He really believed he could win, and he really wanted to win to show what he was capable of. But I think he's shown that anyway with how he handled himself in there with one of the greats of our era. He was in great form going into this fight, obviously having the two back-to-back wins over David Haye, knocking him out twice. Yes, the injury in the first one, but there was no excuses in the second one. Also, he was a former world champion at cruiserweight, beating Olungu Makabu in the third round after being dropped in the first round. So he showed great heart to get up from that and knock Makabu out. Then he fought David Haye's friend, BJ Flores, and stopped him also in the fourth round, and knocked him down a couple of times. And, I mean, BJ Flores was a good fighter. He hadn't been down before. He was very, very durable, and Tony Bellew stopped him. He was showing his power and speed at cruiserweight. That was his weight. And then he even cracked it at heavyweight, really, fighting David Haye and securing his family's future financially with those two fights. Then he came back for Alexander Usyk in the cruiserweight division, which was, I don't really want to say one step too far, because he was doing well in the fight. Yes, he was knocked out and stopped, and Usyk won the day in the end. The fight was going in that direction, but Bellew was tired and Usyk was starting to take over. Had it gone the full 12 rounds, Usyk probably would have nicked it if Tony Bellew managed to stay in there. But, I mean, still, Tony Bellew fought a great fight, a great game plan. He just came up short, and he was stopped. This is the thing with fighters. He's 35 years old. I've always thought that fighters don't get worse with age. They don't struggle with age. What it is, I think, in my personal opinion, is injuries over camp and hard fights, they catch up with an older fighter. So, I mean, look at Vladimir Klitschko against Anthony Joshua. He was on his toes for most of the fight. I mean, he was an old man, 41, but still, he fought well in that fight. That was probably one of his career best performances in there. I've never thought really that age was an issue. I've thought that the harsh training camps, as I said, injuries and difficult fights, being taking a lot of punishment, that is what catches up with the fighter, not necessarily the number that is age itself. I mean, Tony Bellew has never said that he's had injuries, but he obviously has. I've heard that he had a niggle with his knee or something in the first David Haye fight. I mean, Tony Bellew's never one to make excuses, so he'd never say if he had an injury or anything. But I think that all catches up to you as your career goes on, picking up different little niggles and injuries. Some of them just don't go away. They always keep coming back, reoccurring injuries. So I think that is more the fact with fighters getting older, is that catches up with them, not necessarily the number. But anyway, I would like to say a great well done to Tony Bellew for staying in there for so long and outboxing the boxer. As I said, he was outboxing him for the first couple of rounds. I had Tony Bellew 2 rounds up, personally, so he was doing greatly well. And he goes out on a high, even though he lost his last fight. He goes out knowing that he fought anyone and faced anyone, and that was really what he was about and what he wanted to be known for. He never really wanted the glory and to be known as one of the legends of the sport. He just wanted to be known as the fighter, Tony Bellew, who fought anyone. I wish him great retirement and great things for the future, as he now continues his life, as he likes to be called now, Anthony Bellew. Tony Bellew is gone. He is the family man, Anthony Bellew, now, and he deserves all of the spoils, all of what he has earned in the boxing ring. Now he can go on and live his life knowing that he's had a great career. Well done to Tony Bellew.